Bizzibox's expert information on nutrition and mood. What is the link between depression and nutrition?
Well, depression is thought, when it exists as a biological phenomena, to result from having very low levels of serotonin, which is the chemical in your mind that, you know, gives you a good mood. And serotonin can be promoted by eating or supplementing the amino acid, protein is made from amino acids, called tryptophan, and particularly a form of tryptophan called 5-hydroxytryptophan. And if you have enough 5-hydroxytryptophan, you have enough serotonin. Also, omega-3 fats found in oily fish, and particularly one kind called EPA, so you can buy supplements that say that they are EPA rich. This helps the brain to read serotonin. And thirdly, we know that when people have blood sugar dips, their serotonin levels come down. So there's a link between sugar and mood. And if you eat a diet that keeps your blood sugar even, that really helps. There is a particular mineral called chromium, and chromium helps to stabilize blood sugar. And we also know that in many people, chromium helps to improve mood. So the amino acid 5-HTP, essential fat omega-3, eating a diet that balances your blood sugar, and the mineral chromium. These are all some very well-proven ways to help to balance your mood.
How does nutrition help my concentration?
The brain depends on carbohydrate or sugar or glucose for fuel. So if your blood sugar dips, your concentration dips. You just literally don't have that, you know, that sort of brain energy. So eating a diet that stabilizes your blood sugar is vital for concentration. But the brain itself is made out of two kinds of fats, and one are omega-3 fats. So the more omega-3s you get from oily fish and seeds, like pumpkin seeds, flax seeds, that helps concentration. But the other essential fat are called phospholipids. And there's one of these which is called phosphatidylcholine that's very, very important. It's found in eggs. It's also found in brains and organ meats, but most of us not eating much of that. So eggs is the primary source. And it's also found in lecithin. And you can supplement it. So there are some brain food formulas that contain phospholipids. And these are essential for brain function. The mind's memory neurotransmitter is called acetylcholine. So the choline part is literally made from foods such as eggs.
Can changing my diet help reduce stress and anxiety?
You know, nowadays we have a lot of stress and anxiety, and when you understand that is actually a sort of hunter state, because we make adrenaline, and adrenaline turns us, you know, into a hunter. So the question is, how do you turn off adrenaline? By the way, you turn it on with sugar and also with caffeine, so that promotes adrenaline. So one of the first ways to decrease stress is actually not to keep having caffeine. In the short term, it gives you energy, but it actually does make you more stressed. Now, the other way to turn off adrenaline is to make sure your blood sugar level never dips. Because if you haven't eaten and your blood sugar dips, that actually promotes adrenaline, turns you into a hunter, so it makes you more stressed. So here's one of those ironies in life. Exactly at that time when you're most stressed, that's the time when you reach for the chocolate or, you know, more caffeine or cigarettes. And then because you can't relax, you go for the alcohol to help you relax. But actually, it's at the times when you're stressed that you need to eat the best diet and take supplements. The mineral magnesium is very, very calming, both for mind and muscles, helps relax muscles. And they're very, very high in pumpkin seeds, also high in omega-3s. So if you're going to snack when you're stressed, have fruit, which gives you a slow-releasing sugar, plus protein from pumpkin seeds, because protein and carbohydrates stabilize your blood sugar, and also lots of magnesium. And Mulder from X-Files, he's always munching the pumpkin seeds. I think they give you extra sensory perception.
What will help lift my child's mood and concentration?
If you want to maximize your child's performance and mental health, there are three things we know that works. Number one, we have some 16 what we call double-blind controlled trials, showing that if you give children multivitamin and mineral supplements, their nonverbal IQ scores go up. So rule number one is to maximize intake of vitamins and minerals, both from a supplement, I think that's very important, but also from diet. And that means eating whole foods, not refined foods. So it's the brown stuff, not the white stuff, brown rice, brown bread, whole wheat pasta and so on, but also a lot of fruits and vegetables, nuts, seeds, beans. These are all very, very good foods. The second is essential fats. There's a direct link between omega-3 intake and performance at school. We know that children who have attention deficit become much calmer and able to focus if they have essential fats. Personally, I think there's enough evidence to give every child an essential fat supplement, as well as eating more oily fish, nuts and seeds. And then the third factor is sugar. There's a very big link between sugar and impulsive behavior, getting into trouble, behaving badly, not being able to concentrate. So whatever you can do to educate your child to not develop a sweet tooth, for example, giving them water to drink or at least diluted juices and not buying into the whole thing of sugar as a reward, all of that really helps.
www.bizzybox.com